Hi subscribers and viewers, welcome back again to this channel. So this video is just a complement of a video I just did about unboxing UISP Litebeam 5AC Gen 2. Okay, so without wasting time, let me quickly start with what I'm supposed to start with. So as usual with most networking devices, you need to first of all get into the device and then configure your IP, your preferred IP for the device. And mind you, such a device has been pre-configured already, so it comes with a default IP. And in this case, Ubiquiti's default IP is 192.168.1.20. So I need to quickly change my IP into a static IP to enable me to get into this device. So let me go there quickly and change the IP to suit Ubiquiti's IP. Then I can change it to my preferred IP address. A second, please. So being what you know, it's been years now I've been working with Ubiquiti products. Okay. I'll start because of Ubiquiti products. You need to set a static IP for you to gain access into the access point. And the same thing goes with other devices as well. So this is my this is the default IP to get into any Ubiquiti device. Okay, so it has, as you can see, it has acknowledged that I'm inside the same network with the Ubiquiti at this point. So at this time, I've gotten access into the device. The next thing for me is to get access to this device and then we get going. So as you can see, if you type in this default IP coming from Ubiquiti, this is what you are often met with. And so you need to proceed. Click proceed to the IP provided and then you can log in with the default credentials of Ubiquiti. So this is the initial setup. So let me select the country I want to use on my initial setup. I'm using Litebeam. I click on agree to license, then continue. Now I need to set the password. First of all, I need to choose a username. So I'm using this as my username. And the password. This initial setup looks quite different from the usual Ubiquiti setup initiation we know. And I think you don't do so much with regards to this interface. With just your username and password and the selection of your country, it brings you straight to the dashboard. And this is where you can actually pair another device to this particular Litebeam. This is our local device. This is what I'm in. Okay, this is what I'm connected to. And so I need another device here to pair to this device here, to pair to this Litebeam 5AC Gen 2 here, part of it. This is where you can set up your access point. Okay. So in case I click here, it has enabled access points for me. Which means the other paired device should be in the session mode to connect to this device when I've turned it into an access point. And you go on further to select the channel you want, the kind of channel you want to, connect both devices on. Whatever you do on the access point must replicate on the station as well. Right? They need to have one thing in common. The access point needs to be on the same frequency as the station. The moment the access point is on a different frequency and different channel width, and the station is also on a different channel width frequency, there is no way they are going to connect and communicate. That is their meeting point. Okay. And so here you have the chance to also change the antenna gain according to what you intend doing. Okay. You can, right, something like this. You can adjust the distance according to, you know, your setup preferences. These are the places where you can select the channels you want to communicate through to it. Right. Control frequency. So this is where you share the password. So the kind of password you provide here needs to be provided same in the station as well. Okay. That is where you'll be able to actually have a good connection between those two points. And you have the advanced tab where you can adjust certain settings here to suit what you intend doing. Right. Okay. This is the network side of it, where you can change the network settings to suit your network setup. Right, so in case my IP is 192.168.1.88, I need to change this IP to suit my network's IP address as well. So this is where you actually do those changes, and then you can further on provide the DNS. But if you don't want any updates, I mean, if you don't want internet flow through your access point, you can deny the DNS and then just fix in the IP address, which means the access point is just going to be a medium of transferring data and, you know, other services. And then this is where you can turn it into a router mode or a bridge mode. Let's turn it into a router mode, let's see. So if you change it into a router mode, it's going to usher out IP addresses to any devices that connects to it. Okay? So you can turn it into a router mode as well. It has certain services here like the web server, the SSH server, the system log. So with the web server, this is the default port, as we all know. And this port as well. Okay, these are the two ports. If you deny, if you disable it, you are not going to get access through this device on the web interface. So you must know what you're doing before you tamper with this feature here. We have the SSH server, and this is the default port. So at this point, if you want to further protect your SSH port, you can further add a different number to it, and this number must be unique to you alone. Right? Because if you don't have any use for your SSH server, you just disable this as well.
Okay, this is the remote log.
Okay, so if you enable your remote log, it means you want to access this device remotely from a different place outside your network. So if you enable it, you need to actually specify the remote IP here, which obviously will be a public IP. If you are using a DDNS, you need to specify it here. And then the port, maybe you can give it a customized port or leave it this way. Discovery. This feature needs to be enabled on. You know, Ubiquiti has a tool called a discovery tool. In case you have forgotten the IP of your device, you can use this tool to actually identify that particular IP. Or in case you have more Ubiquiti devices in your network and you don't really, you are confused about the whole IP, or you don't even have a clue of them, you can use the discovery tool to have a list of all those IPs, and then you can get going. System has got to do with upgrade of your firmware, changing of the device name. Okay, you can AirView enabled. You know, auto send crash reports. We have the management radio settings as well. You can set your date and time here as well. Your NTP clients, you can set them up here. Okay. Yes, you leave it at default, and then this is where you can actually change your username and set your passwords as well. And then assign if it's you want it to be read only account, you do that as well. And this side is for the location of the device, the latitude and longitude, and the device height as well. The device, we have the device maintenance tab. This point is where you can reboot the device, reset it to default factories, backup configuration with regards to the configs you have on this device, and then you can also upload the configuration as well in case you are done reformatting the device, resetting it and reconfiguring the whole thing. You can just upload your backup configuration from here. So the tools, okay, it has these tools as well. These tools are meant for alignment and then discovery of other devices as well. We have the wave viewform. So at this, you can see some waves going on up here. Some activities are going on here. This has got to do with frequency noise, right? This has got to do with the frequency noise, and this helps you to choose the best frequency for your point-to-point or point-to-multipoint connections. We have the alignment. If I've paired the other device to this particular access point here, you're obviously going to see a kind of activity going on here, right? And this has got to do with the antenna alignment. This is the discovery I was talking about. This is where you'll be able to discover all connected devices here, and this device discovery tool is a standalone software as well, the same way it has been embedded into this interface as well. We have the site survey, the ping between both access points, and this ping determines the time being used to reach both devices. If the time being used to access these two devices or this access point to the other stations is about 1 digit, then you will know that it's okay. If it's about 2 digits, then you know that it's okay. If it's 3, then you should know there might be certain issues going on. I mean 3 and above. Okay. There is the other one, which is a speed test. Speed test has got to do with the speed of data transfer between the access point and the station, or the access point and stations. So this is where you do that. Okay. Specify manually. So you specify the remote ID here. You add the ports and all those things, the duration. Then you add the username and password. Then you click on start. It's going to give you the speed between the two access points. Constellation. I don't have the station connected, so we actually are not going to see anything here. So basically, these are the, you know, features you can play with on this Litebeam 5 AC Gen 2. And I hope you guys have a clue of how you can deal with this device in case you come across it. Right? This is all I can serve you with at this moment. And I'm grateful you guys had a chance to watch this video. Let me show you one thing here. This is the LAN speed. So this is the LAN speed, about 1000 Mbps. Okay. This is very good for point-to-point connections. Okay, thank you very much for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel, like and share my videos as well. Thank you very much again for watching this video. Bye. So when the device is powered on, this is how it looks like. Wow, so beautiful. This is how it looks like.